Okay, guys, welcome back to episode 1 in the series. So today I'm going to be installing some basic plugins, and you can hear a creeper already behind me, or a spider. And yeah, so I'm going to be installing some basic plugins and showing you its configuration. And by basic plugins, I mean Essentials X, Vault, Packet Listener API. I'll talk about Vault and Packet Listener API. They are basically plugins that make your life easier. They are compatible with many plugins, and actually many plugins use them. So yeah, I'd suggest highly that you install them, as they will seriously help you out in your video, your in your server, and they work with a lot of plugins, okay? And Essentials X. You basically install Essential X, and as you can see, it's a zip file. You can extract it and put it in your server. And yeah, that's basically it. Start up your server, give yourself OP if you forgot to. And yeah, let's move into in-game. Okay, guys, so now we're in-game currently. So what I usually do when I get in game, this is when you have a lot of plugins. Type in here slash plugins. So it basically shows you a list of all of the plugins, and if it lights green, as you can see, it's green at the moment. That means the plugin is working perfectly, no problem. And if it shows you a red color, that means that you have a problem in this plugin. So this is really good when you have a lot of plugins and the server has an error. But what is this error exactly? Slash plugins can show you if there's an error in a specific plugin that's causing a server problem. Okay, so now that we talked about that, once you set up your server for the first time, you want to type in the console OP and your name. Don't forget, just don't type slash in the console. You don't have to type slash. And if you type it, you're probably gonna get an error. Just don't type it. Okay, so now I'm going to be talking about some stuff in game that we want to fix in console. And the first basic one is that Dovahmiru joins the game. I'm not really a fan of like the player name and join the game. Like, I don't really, I just typed gay. Whatever. So I'm not really a fan of this. For me, I'd rather go with like a plus player join the game, but I just type in here slash plus and name, you know, any player name, whatever, and the minus name. But that doesn't look that good, honestly. So you can add some color, which we will do in console. So I'll leave the chat color down in the description for the different colors in Minecraft if you don't know them. So let's N6 is gold. I want a gold bracket and a plus, which is light blue, because the NB represents light blue. Gold and the bracket and the player name represented in light blue. So yeah, it looks much better than this, you know, blank, no colors thing. And for the minus, same thing, maybe minus, make it in red. And yeah, that's it. It's looking good. You can change it to whatever you want. It's fully customizable. If you don't even want to your server to show that a player joined or left, you can do that as well. Okay, so another thing that I'm going to be talking about, I have a nickname, and how do I know that? Because this sign, as you can see, it's here. But what if I want to reset my nickname? I just type in here nickname Obamiro. Okay, now my nickname is reset. So when I type in here hello, as you can see, it show. As you can see, it's red, and I really like it. Looks really bad on red because this is the default color. Since you're OP'd, so we can turn it off so it doesn't change a player color name if he has OP. So, and also if you change your nickname, let's just say N6 Romero, you have like this sign, and it represents that this player has a nickname. So I don't really like it, and it kind of makes the name look bad, not to mention the chat and the prefix, which I will talk about in a second. This sign, like, you can remove it easily, and we'll get in that in config. Okay, so now let's talk about the final thing. Oh, not the final thing, the chat. As you can see, it says bracket Dovomiro bracket. And for me, that doesn't look good at all. So I'd prefer, like, if it says Dovomiro and a colon to represent that the chat, you know, hello. That doesn't look that good, but it looks better at least, you know. And you need Vault, by the way. Just install it, please, and Packet Listener API. Don't forget to. So we'll talk about that in config. And the final thing is the sign. So you know when you're in a server and you see like a sign that says disposal. Yeah, and you see like a repair, for example. But it's not working. It's literally a sign like this sign. To essential text, this sign is the same as this sign. But disposal and repair should be like commands, you know. You right click this and you just get rid of stuff. And you have an item here that's kind of that needs fixing, you know. And you right click and you fix the item. But that doesn't work at the moment. We'll get in that in config. So let's move to the config. Okay guys, so now we're in config, and the first thing that you see is the ops name color. It's basically like, it explains itself, you know. So it's 4, so it's not and 4 as in-game, because this is the configuration, just types in here 4. So it says 0 to 9 or AF, these are some colors, and it's set to on to disable. So as you can see, it gets really easy to install. Nickname prefix. It's, you know, you remember this thing which indicates that that's a nickname. So all what you have to do is basically just delete it, leave it empty, you know. Okay, so now this is the max nickname length. I usually leave it on 15. If you want players to have a long nickname or a short nickname, feel free to change it. And yeah, so let's move to the importance of. Okay, so this is the teleport cooldown. So you don't want the player to be spamming slash home, you know, or to be escaping, and teleport delay works hand in hand with the teleport cooldown. So you basically want the player, for example, to wait 3 seconds before he's teleported. This is, most of the servers make it on 3 seconds, and some make it on 5, you can feel free. And the teleport cooldown, so the TPA and the slash home and stuff like that. I'd say a 6 second, you can set it to 100 second, you can set it to 5 minutes, feel free. But make sure that it uses seconds. So if you have any problem converting, you can type in here like 1 minute to seconds. Okay, you can make it 5 minutes to seconds, feel free to change it. Let's get back to the video. Okay, so this is the teleport vulnerability, and if you don't know what it does, read what it does here. The delay in seconds, the player cannot be attacked by other player after having been teleported by command. 4 seconds, feel free to change it. These are basically like really easy to understand, but I'll get into some main stuff right now. This is just social spy commands. So social spy, if you don't know, is a command in game that only admins or moderators, you can set it to whatever you want to have. It basically allows you to see private messages sent. So when a player sends a message to another. So yeah, so the commands. So what commands should you exactly see? Message, slash W, slash R, slash reply, slash mail. You see all of these messages. If you want to remove a specific one, just delete it. But I'm gonna be leaving it. I usually don't mess around with social spy, but if you want to add a command, just feel free. You type in here enter, you type in this thing, and you type in here space, and you know, if there is a command called slash hello, it will be added. Okay, so now let's go down here. So these are player commands. Essential X is a really good program, and they gave you player commands. These are like, what's this called, like permissions. So you don't have to set up permissions if you're lazy. But I'm going to be set up my permissions the way I want them to, because for example they added here clear inventory. You can easily delete it, but I'd prefer adding my own permissions. And it says over here to enable this feature, please set use bucket permissions to false. Use bucket permissions. As you can see, I just set it to false, but I'm going to be leaving it to true because I'm going to set my own commands. Okay, so now we talked in game about how we don't have the repair, disposal, all of this stuff. So right now, I'll explain it real quick. This is a Notepad++ thing. Whenever you add a hashtag to a thing, it's considered as a comment. Yeah, so if you remove the hashtag, it's no longer a comment. So it says here balance, and it's written as a comment. So you want to remove this hashtag. Now you can have color in your signs. Remove this. Now you can have balance. Now you can add buy, sell, trade, free, disposal, warp, kit, and yeah, that's basically it. So make sure you remove this hashtag before it. And yeah, this is sign per use second, so you have a cooldown. I'll just set it to 2 seconds so a player cannot spam it. Okay, so now in game you have a command called slash list. So what is slash list? It shows you players and admins. So there's a list called default or members. This is basically the players, and this is a list called admins. Admins, you can think of them as staff. So I can add in here more ranks, moderator, and yeah, but I'll talk in this in a future video, so you can just ignore it for now. Okay, so this is auto AFK. What's auto AFK? So when a player doesn't move for 300 seconds, it's set here. It says player X or player name is now AFK. You can set it to -1 if you don't want any timeout. And -1, this is auto AFK kick. So you don't want a player to be kicked if he's AFK, just set it to -1. But if you do want him to be kicked, you can set it to 60 seconds. If he goes AFK for 60 seconds, he'll be kicked. Okay? So let's move on to the important stuff. Yeah, here we go. So this is the custom join message. Remember when we talked about it and we said like how I type in a bracket, gold bracket, plus when a player joins and negative when a player leaves. So I'll display it right now on screen what it looks like. So I type in here N6, okay, NB for a plus, N6, N6, and then I have a space. And as you can see, you may use color codes username for player name, okay, and player for the player display name. You can either choose between player or username. Let's go with the username, and I want the username to be displayed in light blue, and be username, okay. Since I'm lady, I'm going to be copying this, putting it in here, and change this. Because this is a quit, you know, I wanted to display a negative in red color, so N4 negative, and the player name has left, you know, that's how you do it basically. And you have this allow silent join, quit, just leave them false. But if you do want to, you can read what it does. Okay, so these are some stuff. I'm just going to be scrolling over them. You guys can read them and they are really easy to understand. Okay, so these are the homes. We'll talk about this in a future video when we set up our permissions. So you can leave this and we'll talk about it soon. This is the economy, the starting balance when a player joins is on 0. You can make it on 500, 1000, 100. I'll just save it on 1k. This is a symbol. You could use any symbol, and if your server has its own currency, any currency, you can just change it here. And yeah, this is the max money. You could literally put it on anything depending on the server. And this is the minimum money. So this is really important. So as you can see, it's a -10,000. That mean a player could have a loan and he has to pay that loan. But I really don't want that in my server. I don't want the player to be in a dead, you know. So you just set it to zero. This will completely disable it. No loan, no anything. And this is the minimum pay amount. You know, some players really spam it, and it used to happen to me. Players spam me like 0.001, and it's really annoying. So I say make the minimum pay amount like 5, maybe 1, depending on you, so players do not spam it. And you could also add a chat control which prevents that. Okay, so now let's get into the essential chat. Okay, so remembering game, I'll show you on screen right now if you don't remember. This was the display thing you see in game, and it looked really bad. Like, it actually looked really bad. So what I'm going to be doing is removing both of these brackets, adding a simple colon, and yeah, that's it. If you want to add a color, for example, and F, which represents white, you can add this as well. Now the player name will be displayed in white, and so as his message. If you want to change the message color only, just come before the message and type and 6. This will make the message gold. Okay, you could also add prefix and suffix, but we will be adding lock perms, and I suggest you don't add it, and you'll see why in a soon video, coming video soon. And yeah, this is essential to protect. So this is like the prevent lava flow, water flow, stuff like that. Feel free to edit it. I'm not going to be going through every single one of it, because it's really easy to understand. And yeah, this is the spawn, prevent the spawning of creature. If a creature is missing, you can add it. So you have creeper false, like it spawns it. If you don't want to spawn a specific thing, so let us just say wolf, instead of false, set it to true, so this does not spawn it. Okay, let's scroll down. This is the anti build. So what's anti build? It prevents player from building stuff. Basically, you can blacklist items, specific items in your server. So as you can see, you have lava, TNT, lava bucket, and you can add items. But I want, this is a survival server, right? So it's okay if players can place lava, TNT, or lava bucket, and you can just save it on like that, blank. And this is alert the player when he's about to use lava, TNT, lava bucket. And yeah, that's basically it. Like, the next thing is the spawn. This is a format when a player enters the server for the first time. Andy is purple, by the way. So if you want to change it, welcome display to the server. You could just change it really easily. Welcome to the server. If you want the server name to change, let us say to any server, Hypixel maybe. Welcome display name, which is me, for example, Dovamiro, to the Hypixel. Let's remove that. Welcome to Hypixel. You see? And this is the kit that's going to be given to the player. We will add kits in the future, and you can give him that kit, which is really cool. And yeah, that's basically it. So thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we're going to be talking about permissions and setting up permissions, prefix, and stuff like that. So yeah, I'll see you next one. Bye.